Hey guys, what's going on? This is Qazi. I'm a colorist and an editor in LA, and mostly I work on car commercials, branded content, stuff like that. There's 10 million ways to do things. As an artist, whatever you're gonna see from me is just my approach, and that's how I do it. And then you guys are more than welcome to add on in the comment section and just let me know what you think or what you would like to see next and stuff like that. We'll just take it from there. This series that I'm working on is called Color Grading One Shot at a Time. This is not about color matching. We're not gonna get into the nitty-gritty of like any and every nuance that goes into color grading. Here, I'm just gonna pick a random shot and we're gonna make it as good as it can get. My goal is to give you guys the logic, give you guys the practical sense, give you guys how it actually works in the real world. I mean, there's 10 million trainings out there where you can go and learn the tools. I'm not gonna focus on that. I wanna focus on when I'm on a job, how do I tackle something? And how do I go about it? I'm gonna show you the systems and processes that I've created and work with so many A-list brands and like how was I able to satisfy my clients yet satisfy myself? Like got away whatever I wanted besides the money from the job, and how does it all play out? So that's what we're gonna do. So this was shot in Canon RAW, and it's a 12-bit image. It's shot with the C200. I'm just gonna show you how I'm gonna do this particular shot. Then tomorrow I can show you a different approach to the shot, and the day after a different approach, and you know, that way I can show you four or five different ways to do the same shot, and then you pick and choose whatever works for you, whatever makes you more efficient. That's the key. Okay, so let's start with the primaries. So I'm gonna use my gain to bring it up, and like let's see where we want to leave it. So this is fine. So now I'm gonna dial my lift down and look at my black levels, bring it up a little bit, and now let's just bring down the mids because it's looking a little washed out. So okay, bring it up a little bit more. I brought up my lift the gain. So this is the game that you got to play. You bring one thing down, you got to bring something else up, and you know, you just keep going back and forth until it looks good, but always push it to the max and then bring it back. So I mean, what kind of look are we going for? Are we going for the moody look and where we can just like really crank the highlights and bring down the midtones and the shadows or the lift? Or are we going for like a low contrast look? Or so I mean, for me, something like that is looking pretty good. We go before and after, and this is like giving me that drama that I was going after, and like just really, really push that exercise, that dynamic range that we get from this camera. That to me is a good starting point. This is my primary node. So in this node, I'm gonna do my contrast, which we just did, and I'm also gonna do my saturation in this node as well, okay? So when we crank our saturation, let's just go all the way. Don't be shy. Like, let's just crank it all the way. So now I'm seeing my colors. Let's dial back a little bit. And you know what? I'm at 89% saturation, okay? Now here's the thing. So let's go in here in Vectorscope and make this a little bit bigger so we can see where we are. So I mean, you know, we're well under where we're, how far we can actually stretch it, okay? Just start big and then shrink until you get to a point where you go, this is perfect, let's just leave it there. Okay, so now you see all this grain. This grain is not pretty at all, okay? So you can use Neat and that can remove it, but that will just slow down your system like a mother. Like it will slow it down so much. So what I would do, I would hit Shift S, which will give us a node prior to our primary node. And then in that node, I'll show you a quick tip. And this is my secret sauce. This is a game changer. This is something where you want to pause, take notes, watch it again. this is just the dialed in settings. Just do it and it's game over. Most of the time, it's gonna get you where you need to be and without any latency, without any lag. So what I would do is I would just set this to temporal NR to one frame. I'll take this up to around 4.85-ish, which is great. And then here, I will take this off and I will take my chroma to about 6.8, maybe 7, okay? So now if I turn this on and off, now mind you, I'm zoomed in like 600%. So that's why it's a bit too exaggerated. But just even look at right here in my scopes, how much it's taken out and without any degradation, okay? So if I move back right here, and now if I show you on and off, like the noise is gone. You always wanna start with the noise reduction and not add noise reduction at the end. And the reason being is that then everything that you do afterwards is gonna be so much cleaner. When you're doing qualifiers, it's always a great idea to run noise reduction pass first to get the cleanest key. Okay, cool. So this was one note, okay? We've come a long way. Obviously, your shot is never complete until it has a window or a couple of windows. Like, you just have to window out everything. So in this one, we can just do a simple one. And one thing that you gotta keep in mind that in Resolve, softness is everything. Like, you just gotta soften the F out of things. Like, just crank it until you crank it no more. So like here, I would do something like that. I will reverse it and then use different wheels and just see what works, but I start with the mid-tone usually, and then I would go before and after. And you know, this is also helping us with the noise situation on the left, top left corner. So it's gonna help us with that a little bit. So then, I mean, just really see, and plus it's bringing back a little bit more saturation in the highlights too, which I like. I feel like for today, this is all I wanted to show you. So that's one way to do it. Most of the work was done in one note, just with our primaries, and then we cranked the saturation. We had some noise issue that we tackled, and then we added a vignette. You can isolate things. I can crank up, I can create a window around this and saturate my blues. I can create a window around this and cool it off a little bit, create a window around that and bring it down a notch. You know, there's so many things that I can do. But guys, one thing that you need to understand is that you can spend 7 hours on one shot, but when you're working on a project, ask your client, what are you looking for? What's the objective? What's the goal? What do you need? I say color grading is all about troubleshooting. You're looking at a shot as a problem, and then how are you gonna fix it? Anyways, this is my first video, so I wanted to just tell you a little bit about myself and what to expect. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one.